I need it when I'm falling apart and bury my head in your hands.
My baby Ronald. I didn't even know where to begin, and I'll try to keep it short. I can't believe this day is finally here. I had pretty much decided I was never getting married, and then you come into my life. I never dreamed I'd have someone like you, but I'm so glad you came all the way to Buffalo to find me. You're the sweetest, most thoughtful, and loving guy I could ever hope for. I know it's cliche, but you really do make me laugh every time when I don't even want to smile. I can be in the worst mood driving to work, but when I get out of my car and see you standing there, I immediately smile, even though I try not to. Seeing you never gets old. I truly don't know what I'd do without you. You make me feel safe. I never thought I'd be so comfortable with someone like I am with you. Thank you so much for loving me and being my best friend. I know it's not easy, and my moods and anxiety are a lot to deal with. But you love me regardless, and I am forever grateful for that. Even though I rejected you 8 times, you never gave up on me, and I promise I will never give up on you or our marriage. I will cry with you during the bad times and laugh with you during the good ones. I'm so excited for our life together, with a cat, maybe a dog, and maybe a kid or two. I'm so lucky I get to be your wife. You're my person, always. I can't wait to be Mrs. Roque. See you at the altar, my love. Love, Kelly. It took me
by surprise, but I don't mind. Hi, baby. We are nearly there. In just a few more hours, I'll finally call you mine. And after all this, you aren't going. Just remember, I love you, and I can't wait to spend the rest of my life with you. You got this. I ate you.
Marriage is an ancient human tradition. The personal and social merits that accompany the bonds of marriage have led to its continued endurance through the ages and have paved the way for us to be standing here before you, before family and friends, celebrating the union between these two people. I would like to read an excerpt from a book by Robert Fulghum called The Beginning to End, The Union. You have known each other from the first glance of acquaintance to this point of commitment. At some point, you decided to marry. From that moment of yes to this moment of yes, indeed you have been making promises and agreements in an informal way. All those conversations that were held riding in a car or over a meal or during long walks, all those sentences that began with, I will and you will and we will, and all those promises that are unspoken matters of the heart. All these common things and more are the real process of a wedding. The symbolic vows that you are about to make are a way of saying to one another, you know all things, all those things we've promised and hoped and dreamed? Well, I meant it. Every single word. Look at one another and remember this moment in time. before this moment, you have been many things to one another. An acquaintance, a friend, a companion, a lover, a dancing partner, and even a teacher. For you have learned much from one another in this last few years. Now you shall say a few words that take you across a threshold of life, and things will never quite be the same between you. For these vows, you shall say to the world, "This is my husband, this is my wife." We come now to the words Ronald and Kelly want to hear the most today. The words that take them across the threshold from being engaged to being married. A marriage, as most of us understand it, is a voluntary and full of commitment. It is made in the deepest sense to the exclusion of all others, and it is entered into with the desire and hope that it will last forever. We will now do the declaration of intent for the couple. We come now, may the promises you make to one another today be lived out to the ends of your life. Tomorrow can bring you the greatest of joys, but today is the day it all begins. Ronald and Kelly, do you, with your family and friends as your witnesses, present yourself willingly and of your own accord to be joined in marriage?
We do.
And we'll now do the exchange of vows. Ronald and Kelly. Ronald, do you take Kelly as your cherished wife in front of these witnesses and promise to stay by her side through sickness and health, joy and sorrow, and as long as you both shall live?
I do.
Kelly, will you take Ronald as your cherished husband in front of these witnesses and promise to stay by his side through sickness and health, joy and sorrow, so long as you both shall live?
I do.
The wedding rings, please. Just hold on to it. The wedding rings perfectly symbolize the never-ending love you two have for each other. By exchanging these rings, you solidify a lifelong commitment to one another. The rings serve as a welcome and constant reminder of the bond you've formed with your partner. Ron, please repeat after me. I, Ronald, give you Kelly.
I, Ronald, give you Kelly.
This ring as a symbol of my enduring love.
This ring as a symbol of my enduring love.
Just as the circle of the ring completes itself.
Just as the circle of the ring completes itself.
So you complete me.
So you complete me.
Kelly. I, Kelly, give you Ronald.
I, Kelly, give you Ronald.
This ring as a symbol of my enduring love.
This ring as a symbol of my enduring love.
Just as the circle of the ring completes itself.
Just as the circle of the ring completes itself.
So you complete me.
So you complete me.
Ronald and Kelly, by the power vested in me by Universal Life Church and by the state of New York, I am pleased to announce you, the husband and wife, sealed together by law and in love, we are all honored to bear witness. Ron, you may kiss Kelly. Ladies and gentlemen, it is my deep, deep honor to present to you for the very first time, Mr. and Mrs. Ronald and Kelly Roque.
I decided, okay, I'm not going to be friends with someone like her. She probably hates my guts already anyway. So later she dropped by Gabe's in my room, and I seriously thought she came by to just murder us. But it turns out that she was also friends with Gabe. By the way, tangent, roommate of the year, century. She's a really awesome roommate, really awesome person, but she's taken. So and the fact that I'm publicly speaking and wearing a pink dress kind of attests to that. And then I also met her parents, and I realized where she got all her awesome qualities from. Anyway, so knowing her, I knew that her husband will also be amazing. They met at work when I was told he was annoying. Sorry. I don't know what he did to tone it down, but once they started dating, I could see how much of a match he was for Kelly. They worked through their problems as a team. They take care of each other, support each other. Ron knows her favorite foods, her favorite holidays, favorite books, and he comes up with unique ways to show her how much he loves her. Ron, may you never have beans on your windshield and a potato in your exhaust pipe. Take care of her, because I'm watching you. That being said, please everyone raise a glass, and I wish you guys the greatest of happiness in your life. I don't know if I'm supposed to give this to you.
I love you.
I don't know who I'm supposed to give this to. Oh, thank you.
Great job, Nicole. Yeah, one more time for Nicole, right? Good job.
Ta'alofa. For those of you that know, that means hi in Samoan. So, hello, my name is Floyd Talamoni, and I am from American Samoa, and I'm the best man for Ronald Roque. And on behalf of Ron and Kelly, I would like to thank you, family, friends, honored guests, wherever you are, for attending this memorable and beautiful event for Ron and Kelly, or Kelly, Kelron, whatever you guys call yourselves now. I don't know. Whatever it is that you guys are doing in this season. So quick backstory before I read this short and sweet best man speech. Ron and I, we met in high school back in American Samoa. For those of you that don't know where American Samoa is, Google it. I'm tired of explaining where it is. But we were not best friends freshman year. We were literally fighting over the best friend award with this other guy named Joe. Needless to say, I won. Whatever he says, don't believe him. I won that award. So freshman year, we hated each other's guts, fighting over the best friend award. And then sophomore year came, we found out that we had more in common than the guy that we were competing for. So from then on, you know, we just went to become the best of friends, doing things that high school boys would do in high school, you know, trigonometry, calculus, you know, important high school things that high school boys would do. Yeah. So that from there on, from 2005 to 2008, late 2018, early 2019, me and Ron stayed in contact. You know, whenever we met each other, we would pick off as if we were still back home on the islands. And then late 2018, early 2019, he met someone other than me that, you know, he shares his heart with now. No. But I'm glad he did, because from there it really changed him. And from there, I seen the love that Ron gives me and to Kelly, which is very beautiful. Actually, it's even more, and you're lucky to have a man like him. Amen. So with that being said, let me read what I wrote down before I go off the wall. Ron, you've always been the most loving, intelligent, caring, honest, and stern man that I know and love. You stay loyal to your family and friends and stand firm on your morals. You've gone through struggles that almost made you quit your job, school, and even life. And even you've gotten your heart broken to the point where you believe love would never find a way back into your life. Been broke, hungry, crying, in pain, and yet here you are on the happiest day of your life with the love of your life. Uso, I'm telling you, all of that was worth it, because all of that built you into the amazing man to love and protect this amazing woman. So with that being said, Word of advice for the groom. Whenever you're wrong, correct yourself. Whenever you're right, shut up. Don't say anything. And on top of that, and everyone, three cheers for the bride and groom. Hip hip.
Hooray!
Hip hip.
Hooray!
Hip hip.
Hooray!
Thank you, and Ron and Kelly, thank you for having us celebrate your special day. Mahalo.
Thank you.